أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب الناس، ملك الناس، إله الناس. الحمد لله فرض الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ثم أما بعد، إن بنيم في الله the most beneficent, the most merciful. All praise and thanks due to Allah, the Lord of the world, and peace and blessing upon the last of the prophets and messengers Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon his family and his companions and ever follow him with the benevolence till the day of resurrection. My dear respected brother and sister Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As we mentioned before, the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was walking with Mu'adh ibn Jabal, and he asked him, Ya Mu'az, do you know what is the duty of the Muslim for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Mu'az ibn Jabal, he need to know the answer. And one of the good manner of the Sahaba, radiallahu anhu wa ardahum, always, if they don't know anything, is to tell the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and his messengers knows best. We don't know. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he walked with Mu'az for an hour without giving him answer. And then he asked him the question again, Ya Mu'az, or different question, Ya Mu'az, you know what is the right of the Muslims from Allah Azza wa Jal? He said, Ya Rasulullah, Allahu wa Rasuluhu a'lam, Allah and his messengers knows best. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he answered the questions he asked to Mu'az. He said, the right of Allah Azza wa Jal from his creation, from his people, to worship him without commit blasphemy with Allah Azza wa Jal, without making partner with Allah Azza wa Jal. And he said to him, and you know what is the right of the people from Allah Azza wa Jal if they do so? If they worship Allah Azza wa Jal without having partner with Allah Azza wa Jal, if they worship Allah Azza wa Jal and they said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day, he tell Abu Huraira, he said, Ya Abu Huraira, go and tell the people whoever died. And last word he said, La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. I guarantee for him he's going to go to Jannah inshaAllah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said to Mu'az, if a person die on this way, the way of the shahada of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, Allah Azza wa Jal, he's not going to punish him, he's not going to torture him, he's not going to put him in the hellfire. Guarantee, inshaAllah, Allah will take him to Jannah. So my brother, if you understand the hadith, there is a right and duty. There is a right for you from Allah Azza wa Jal, and this right, Allah Azza wa Jal, he give it to you. You didn't take it because you are smart, or because you are strong, or because you are rich, or because you nothing. Allah Azza wa Jal, he give it to you. He give you a lot of right. But there is also duty, you have to do it. If you take your right, you have to do your duty. That's fair. You cannot just take, and you never give back. And what Allah Azza wa Jal is asking you to give him, is just worship him. That's all. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. The only purpose I create mankind and jinni, just to worship me. Nothing else. مَا أُرِيدُ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ رِزْقٍ وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ يُطْعِمُونَ. I don't need any risk from them. I don't need them to feed me. The fact is, Allah Azza wa Jalla, He's the one who send our risk. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, He's the one who feed us. So He doesn't need us for anything. So, if you do that, you have so many rights from Allah Azza wa Jal. But you have so many duty as well. And today the duty we're going to talk about it, my brothers and sisters, the duty of the deen. Because we said already last lecture, you get all your rights from Allah Azza wa Jal. No one of us did get his rights from Allah Azza wa Jal. Before even Allah Azza wa Jal created Adam, he created everything for Adam. He make everything ready for him. When Adam come to the dunya, he didn't say, Ya Allah, where is the air? Oh, all right, we'll make air. Ya Allah, where is the water? I'm thirsty. All right, we'll make water. Never. Adam, when he came, he found everything ready. Air, water, trees, everything. Sun, moon, whatever you think about it, Allah Azza wa Jal make it ready. Even in your body, Allah Azza wa Jal make a system now. The scientists, the ulama, they find out miracles in your body. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned that in the Quran, وَفِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Inside of yourself, there is miracle, but you don't see it. You don't see it. So, Allah Azza wa Jal give you all your right. Now you must think about the duty to Allah Azza wa Jal. And the very important things to think about it, my brother, what is my duty for my very important things in my life? The deen, the religion. What is my duty? What should I do to my deen? Allah Azza wa Jalla, my brother, He sent for us two things in this deen. Fard, obligatory, and the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The fard of Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent fard, obligatory, things you have to do. And the fard, as the ulama said, is the things, if you do it, you get reward. And if you don't do it, you get punishment. That's a fard. You have to do it, you have to pray. If you don't pray, you get punishment. You have to give you zakat money. If you don't do it, there is punishment. You have to make hajj if you have the right condition, if you meet the condition. Health, safety, and ability. So you can do it, you're healthy, yes. You got finance, you got money, yes. There's safe to travel, yes. You have no excuse, go and make hajj. If you don't do it, there is punishment. If you die, as the Prophet said, if a person, he passed 5 years, and he got the ability, and he got the safety, and he got the money, everything, and he refused to make hajj, if he die, he should choose another religion, not Islam. Because Allah Azza wa Jalla give him everything, but he still don't want to go for hajj. He got the money, he's healthy, he's safe, everything is fine. Why don't go for hajj? So if you don't do the hajj, the fard, Allah Azza wa Jalla, there is punishment for that. So everything in Islam, my brother, Allah Azza wa Jalla, when He tells us something about the fard, there is a reward of that. But if you don't do it, there is a punishment. That's why in the hadith of Abu Huraira, when Allah Azza wa Jalla said, "من عاد لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب." That's the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whoever take my wali as an enemy, I will fight him. I will make war against him. And that this hadith, we talk about it today, my brother, in the khutbah. Allah is a great hadith. If we understand this hadith, you need to be wali of Allah Azza wa Jal. And some people, they think the wali, he's the one, like he must be knowing in front of the people, my brother. Some wali you don't know. There is some wali, Allah Azza wa Jal hide these people. He could come to the lecture between us. He's sitting humble. And we don't know him. He doesn't come and be in the picture and talk and take videos. Nobody knows him, but he's a wali of Allah Azza wa Jal, much better than anyone else. So it's not necessary to think the one he talk or the sheikh or whatever, he's a wali, no, Allah. It could be one for the people sitting. He doesn't even come in front, he doesn't even talk, nobody hear him. He come maybe just to clean the masjid. That's all what he do. But he got connection between him and Allah Azza wa Jal, and he's a wali of Allah Azza wa Jal. And this one, if somebody make anything bad to him, anything wrong with him, the one is going to fight him is Allah Azza wa Jal. Not anybody. مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا فَقَدْ أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. So be careful to come near of any wali of Allah Azza wa Jal. That's why always, if you see somebody praying and doing good things, don't harm him, don't abuse him. But you don't know, maybe he's a wali of Allah Azza wa Jal. So, and also the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدٌ بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّا افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. We said before, my brother, there is different between the word of مُخْلِص in Arabic, مُخْلِص and مُخْلَص. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. Choosing. مُخْلِص, he's the person, he make effort to come close to Allah Azza wa Jal. He make his best to be close to Allah Azza wa Jal. He always have sincerity to make his action. Everything he make it with intention to Allah Azza wa Jal. That's مُخْلِص. Somebody, He's doing his best to come close to Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's what we call it mukhlas. But al-mukhlas, the one Allah Azza wa